I think for starters, ne, gender-based violence, it is a reality. It is happening, and it has no class, it has no race, it has no age group. It is there. Unfortunately, the government has really tried in putting so much in fighting the gender-based violence, but we seems to be losing the battle. I think most of the things that the people must understand, especially the country that we are in. Yes, we must look at the factors that maybe are making our fight not winnable. One of the things that I've looked at as a detective that has been working with these gender-based violence cases, culture plays a big role also, and the religion. I'm gonna clarify it by saying, okay, by culture, I'm Zulu, as much as I'm a detective. In our culture, we were raised that if you're a woman and you are getting married to a man, if the man is hitting you or the man is doing something that you don't like, you must keep it as a secret between you and your husband. If it is getting worse, you're told to speak to your mother-in-law. But now let us look at what has been happening with the gender-based violence. What has been happening is that here is a wife, young or old, that is having a problem with her husband. Then, because of our culture, she won't report to her maternal family. She will report to the in-laws. The in-laws who will start to influence first by saying, "Don't open a case against your husband. It's gonna be a family matter that we can sit down and talk to him." We have lost most of our women through the cultural practices that are not favoring our women as victims of gender-based violence. It is not only happening to Zulu culture. I'm using the Zulu example because I'm Zulu by culture. It is happening in all cultures and in all races. The families are thinking they can have control over the abuser by speaking to him, by saying this and that, not knowing that the deeper problem with an abuser is that this person is sick psychologically. He needs more than the family can convince her to stop abusing. Another thing that I'm looking at as a detective, you know that an abuser, when he starts, he never stops. That's the bottom line. We don't have a solution as a justice system to that one. Yes, we do have the psychologists that are coming in to speak to the abusers, maybe in the form of a marriage counseling. But honestly speaking, it is not working. And that's the truth that must be known. So you'll find that this is a woman who is a victim in the situation of the gender-based violence. She really loves her husband or her boyfriend. She is committed to this relationship or to this marriage. But she is not even aware that she's living with a very sick person psychologically that can harm him anytime. Yes, there are counselors that will come because you'll find that in some stages, even if a person before she can even open a case, you must know that the person before she can open a case of gender-based violence, she's having her own friends, she's having her own people that she's confiding in. In most cases, the people, they will be like, "Ah, why can't you leave him? Mina won't allow a man to do that." They don't understand the depth. Here is a person that is saying, "I'm committed. There's no other man that I want to be involved with except this man." And another thing that our victim and our complainants, they don't understand. No matter what, you cannot change a person. A person can change himself.